basically, I had bought the ceramic bearings for the Kershaw Lucha from Flytanium, and then I was going to buy the handles. I ended up not getting the handles, and then they fucking sold out, so, you know, now I'm on the list with everybody else to get a set of those. Meanwhile, I had these bearings sitting around, and, you know, I was just... When I had got the Serpent Striker, it, like I had said before, you know, I needed to kind of like put it together, Loctite everything. Some of the bearings were flipped around because I think when they get imported into the US, so they come in pieces and then they get put together through the distributors. So anyway, it is a nice knife, but even with it being a nice knife for the price point, you know, which they go anywhere from, like, I think I've seen them as low as 130, but I bought mine off PVK. I don't like waiting, you know, a bunch, you know, go through a bunch of bullshit with having to worry about it going through customs and all that kind of stuff. So I paid a little more. I think I paid 180, something like that. So I had these bearings. The main complaint that I had with the Serpent Striker really was just that it seemed kind of light. It seemed very blade biased. And it did have a little bit of play for a bearing knife. Now, if this was on bushings, it wouldn't be, you know, really questioned at all, and you could kind of tune it a little bit. With bearings, you're kind of stuck with whatever it is that you get, you know, when you buy it. So, with that being said, I was looking at those bearings, and I had mentioned to somebody in the comments on my Serpent Striker video, Serpent Striker 2, that I would look at trying to see if these would actually fit into these Lucha bearings would fit into the Serpent Striker. So I went ahead and did that, and it actually made a huge difference. One of the other questions that people had regarding that kind of a bearing swap was the issue with the stock bearings, and just kind of wanted to do, if I could get these fuckers out of the bag, is just kind of go over. When you're dealing with plastic like this, and then everything else, you know what I mean? Like, the liners are machined, the blade's going to be machined. It doesn't make a lot of sense to put plastic bearings up against machined parts, because the point of machining things is that it becomes more precise rather than, like, casting or anything like that. So when you use plastic bearings, you're going to have a lot of high and low spots. Now, granted, this is a Chinese knife, so you're not going to get real, you know, high-end machining anyway, so you may have high and low spots on your blade or your liners or whatever anyway. They're probably not going to be you know, anything you could check with even just basic calipers. It's going to be very minimal. Calipers, depending on how much money you want to spend, you know, you could be looking at, you know, plus or minus 0.3 or 0.5 or whatever. I think mine are 0.3. But with these plastic bearings, you know, they're just very shitty, and they almost don't quite fit the knife right. So the Lucha bearings, I measured them with my calipers first. Everything lined up perfectly with them, as far as size going into the pivots and all that kind of stuff. They fit right into the little like the kind of chamfer that goes inside here for the bearing seat, I should say, not chamfer. They sit in there perfectly. And once I did that, it actually eliminated really any play. You can see for a Serpent Striker, that is very minimal. And the issue that, or not issue, but complaint that I had about this being somewhat blade biased kind of seemed to go away once I swapped out these bearings. I think these shitty plastic bearings were creating a lot of drag on the handles. And no matter what you do to adjust them or oil them or anything like that, it just wasn't really enough to, you know, really kind of help with anything. They just kind of, it is what it is when you get them. So I think these are like $9 or something like that on Flytanium's website. I went ahead and just bought another set the other day because obviously I used mine on my Serpent Striker too. But man, it really made a huge difference on this knife as far as how it flips, how it feels. I don't really, you know, I don't flip it a ton because I have a bunch of other shit that I'm, you know, flipping if I even have time to do that. But it does feel a lot better, and I feel a lot better about carrying it around and actually having to use it if I had to use it. So with that being said, you know, a cheap upgrade for this thing to make this thing feel like, you know, something in the $300 range for fucking $10, like, jump on it, go ahead and get them. I know that, you know, combining parts from one knife to another knife, even different brands and all that, is nothing new in this community. People use standardized hardware and things like that. Pivots, screws, bearings, all that kind of shit, they're all going to be interchangeable. Not very many people are making their own hardware. They're buying this hardware from a company that makes hardware and putting it in their knives. So, you know, trying to find these little things where this fits this knife and this knife and this knife, you know, those things really help out a lot if you lose something, if you break something, or just improving something like this. So anyways, I hope that helps out. I definitely recommend it. I wanted to wait to do this video, you know, before I got my other set, because, you know, I wanted to flip it a little bit and all that kind of stuff. But I ended up going and just order another set, and kind of, you know, if they sell out now, then they sell out now. And hopefully, God willing, I'll get my fucking handles this year for the Lucha. Otherwise, I'm just going to unload that thing. It is god-awful heavy. But anyway, it's a whole different deal. Thanks for watching. And again, if you guys have any questions or suggestions in the comments, I have another video I'm going to be doing shortly for the Squid Trainer 3.5. that I just got, so we'll be doing that. But yeah, if you guys have any questions or suggestions, you know, throw them my way. Again, this channel is not about, you know, it's about doing stuff that other people aren't doing to kind of help the community out. So suggestions and all that are really what are going to keep these videos coming. If I have to come up with my own ideas, I have kids, I have, you know, other things going on in my life, I can't just sit around and brainstorm shit to fucking make videos on. But anyway, thanks a lot for watching. Take care. Bye.